Hi, little bear. You're very cute.
Hi guys, so this week is the first Malazan week. We've been reading Gardens of the Moon, we just started. And I just want to start off by saying that a lot of you guys that are buddy reading this with me in the Facebook group are so fun and hilarious. You guys all have such a great sense of humor, and I'm already having so much fun with this buddy read, which I'm really grateful for, because this is an intimidating book series. Everybody speaks of it very highly, but also they talk about how it's kind of an undertaking to get into the series. So I was a little nervous to get into it, but all of you have made it so fun already. So I just wanted to start off by saying thank you. On that note, Gardens of the Moon so far has been, I don't know the right word to describe it. I suppose you could say interesting. It's been interesting. I don't even know that I can say it's been enjoyable, because I don't know what's going on. It's kind of beyond the typical epic fantasy I don't know what's going on introduction, because we're already a quarter of the way through the book now that it's the end of the first week. And usually at a quarter of the way through an epic fantasy story, you have some characters you're rooting for, or characters at the very least that you kind of like, and then you've got people you hate. You have a vague sense of what's going on. I don't know if I do yet. A lot of you have made it clear that it's okay and you don't have to, but I do have I'm gonna try my best to summarize so far. It's gonna be spoilery, so if you don't want spoilers for Malazan, you can skip ahead to when I talk about some other stuff. But so far, there's a young man named Perrin, and he is the boy in the prologue who is like, I'm gonna be a soldier. And then there's a guy that's like, you should not be a soldier. Don't do it.
He's like, I'm gonna be a soldier.
And he does become a soldier, because then 7 years later, he's now a soldier. The Empress is blue. And then there are bridge burners who just seem like a certain sect of the military, but a bunch of them died in an attack that may or may not have been a mage who is betraying the Blue Empress. We have a sorceress named Tattersail who's like, I'm around 200 years old and I have a lover and he's kind of soft, but I like him. And that dude dies immediately. Tattersail is like, hey, what's up, Whiskey Jack? And they kind of buddy up. But he kind of feels bad for Sari, who is the little girl that early in the book was possessed, kind of. There's some shadow people with their hounds, their dogs, and they kill a bunch of people as a diversion. And that's how Perrin is kind of tied to Sari, because ever since then, the adjunct for the Empress was like, you gotta find what the heck went down here, so look into that Fisher family. Then Sari kills him, but he doesn't quite die. And now he's back, and one of the hounds tries to get him. And then Tattersail and the marionette guy, who I didn't realize was literally attached to, his soul has been attached to, puppet? I thought it was a weird analogy at first. I'm like, oh no, I guess he is a puppet. Anyway, the two of them managed to not get killed by this hound thing. And that's the first part of Gardens of the Moon. How well did I do? Did I do decently? I can't tell. Also, random little fun tidbit. I watched part of this video that one of you in the Facebook group posted with the author talking about this series, and he pronounces it not Malazan, not Malazan, but Malazan. I have never heard anybody else call it Malazan before. Even the audiobook narrator is like, nah, it's Malazan. Getting into some non-spoiler thoughts for this though, I definitely think that if I hadn't heard everybody say, you gotta persevere, keep reading, at least read a couple of the books, I don't know if I would want to continue reading this story, because I currently have no emotional connection basically at all to anything. So if I hadn't known going into it to be wary of the fact that it's very dense initially, I don't know if I would have wanted to continue, but I do think knowing that is helping. I'm definitely just being patient with it, maybe more so than I would be normally for a story. And I also am just finding it so much fun getting to see all of your first impressions as well. And those of you who have read it, it's just really cool to see your excitement about having other people read it. So for those of you that want to get into this story, I'm having a good time buddy reading it. That would be, I think, the way to do it. And on top of all of that, my husband is actually buddy reading it also, which is really exciting. And it's really nice to be able to bounce off of him. So yeah, highly original, definitely feels very unique, but it's not entertaining yet. That is not enjoyable. I don't love anybody. I'm just getting to know this world. That's what I'll say so far. So during this last week, I picked up a couple other books for those that care. I think this is also a good way to maintain your sanity, is a very dramatic way to put it. But as far as making sure your reading is still fun, I think it's a good idea if you're gonna pick up Malazan to maybe also take a break, pick up something fun, and then you can come back to Malazan. It doesn't feel as daunting that way. So that's what I did. I read two other books already this week, which is pretty good for me because I'm a pretty slow reader. But I read The Wicked Deep and Serpent and Dove. Serpent and Dove is brand new, and it follows this girl who is a witch by birth, and then a guy who's a witch hunter, and through some interesting circumstances, they end up married to one another, and the witch hunter doesn't know that the girl is a witch. And it's very French inspired, and it was definitely one of those, it would be equal parts plot based off of, you know, her being a witch and people after her, and then equal parts will they, won't they? It does feel way more new adult to me than young adult because there's quite a bit of cursing. And I know I don't curse, but I also am not like, oh no, a curse word, ah. I mean, like, they say the F word quite a bit. And there's also some just kind of saucy stuff in the story, references to things, them consulting with prostitutes. So anyway, it was enjoyable, definitely very entertaining. And I'll have a review up for that very soon. The Wicked Deep, this is a very small book. It was around 300-ish pages. And I would say that this is a great story if you are just looking to read something quick and very easy to get into. It's our own world, but it follows a town in Oregon with some people believing there's a curse because there were some, again, witches. So two stories of witches. There were these girls that 200 years ago were accused of witchcraft. They were drowned. And now every year, at a certain time of the year, boys start drowning and they think it's because these sisters have come back to get revenge. And our main character, she is just a high school girl who is kind of scared of all this. She does believe it exists. And then things start getting kind of trippy when she may or may not get more involved with things than she was expecting. I mean, I enjoyed it. I read it in basically a day, but I enjoyed it if I just had stopped and didn't read the last page and a half. I didn't like the last page and a half, so I just pretend that last page and a half didn't happen. And then I would say I enjoyed the book a lot more. It's kind of just almost like a grim fairy tale. If you like that kind of stuff, I think you'll like this. So that's been my reading this week. Some witches and some Malazan. It's been a good time so far. I'm enjoying my reading this month. And since my husband is also reading Malazan, I asked him if he wanted to record some of his thoughts. So we're gonna switch now to Sean's take on Gardens of the Moon thus far.
All right, kiddos, this is Sean here. I am killing some time because Elliot is teaching violin students and I accompanied her today. So I am participating willingly and excitedly in the Malazan Gardens of the Moon read along. I've been out of the fantasy game, so of course here I am picking a really difficult one to start reading. But I'm doing okay. I'm doing all right. I'm enjoying the writing style. There's not paragraphs about the type of rug that's furnishing a room or long, let's talk about the landscape and geography and mountain ranges and streams and planes. That's cool. I don't know what any of these people's motivations are, except we don't like Moonspawn. Some people don't like Moonspawn. The Empress doesn't seem to like the Moonspawn. What is Moonspawn? I think it's a place. I like some of the names, like Whiskey Jack. I know how to say that. Sorry, it's another good name. And Tattersail. Those are all great names. However, there are also names like this.
What is this? Kaaz de Avore. It's a silly name. He should have been named Rugged Shovel.
Basically, the takeaway of Gone is some sort of gods. They're meddling. There's gods of darkness. Hood. Another word I can say. Anywho. I like it, but I don't know what's happening.
Anyway, I hope all of you have a great rest of your week. For those of you that want to chat spoilers in the comments for any of these stories, really, just make sure you put spoilers so that nobody accidentally gets spoiled. But anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.